Hello friends, good morning and good evening everyone. Your ALP here. So today we are with a wonderful topic, DC motor design. So DC motor plays an important role. Everyone appreciate this. Why? Because these DC motors are the basic configuration for all the machines we are using. It may be transformers, it may be induction motor, it may be synchronous machines, or whatever the electrical machine. So DC motors forms a basic concept for all. So I'm just starting with this DC motors so that I can get some better understanding on all the design aspects. So to explain this, I'm just starting with one DC motor design. So the design problem is design a separately excited industrial motor, say of 240 volts capacity. So industrial motor of 240 volts and of four pole, and this is of 75 kilowatt rating. So this is the capacity, and this is the number of pole, and this is the terminal voltage. And let us consider the rating is a continuous rating, and it is of 1000 rpm. So whatever synchronous speed is there, let's consider this is of 1000 rpm. And similarly, so the motor is screen protected and of class B insulation, and the machine is built in with a standard frame of 400 mm diameter. So 400 mm diameter. So this is the main problem, and the motor is fed from SCR bridge rectifier. So for example, say this is the DC motor, and say this is the DC motor, and we are giving supply to it, and this is fed by the thyristor bridge rectifier. So this is the design problem. So how we will design it, where to start and where to end, what are the different things we have to calculate, we are going to see or observe in this video. This video will be in a different number of parts for each topic, or for each main parameter calculation. I will be posting like a one part. For example, there are different aspects. So let's say this is the DC motor. So I'm just trying to draw the isometric view. So say this is the armature. So here you have number of slots. So say this is the shaft extension. This is the shaft extension, and we have number of conductors here. This is the armature conductor. So this is the length. This is the length of the shaft, and similarly, this is the diameter of the armature. So what is the diameter of the armature? These are the main dimensions D and L. We are going to calculate it simultaneously. For supplying this DC motor, we are using commutator also here. So you have commutator bars, and you have some brush arrangement here. So this we have to consider. So to these brushes we are giving supply, and it is converting into the mechanical energy in the motor. So the slots will be like this. So on the other end, we may have some extension, say for example that is a ball bearing and all. So this is the armature arrangement. Similarly, we have stator arrangement also. How stator looks like? So in DC machine, I'm just trying to draw. For example, this is I'm just trying to draw four pole machine. Say this is another pole. Say this is another pole, and say this is another pole. So this is a four pole machine. So in this four pole machine, you have different configurations. Say for example, this is the armature now. So it won't be like whatever I drawn. It is not like rectangle or square, but generally the pole shoe will be there. Just to take care of a circular shape, it will be like pole shoe. We will say pole arc also. Yeah, it will be like this. Okay, so this is the field system. This is the field system we can say, and you have yoke arrangement also. For housing all these poles, you need a yoke arrangement. The yoke will be like this. whatever I am drawing in blue color, that your yoke will be like this, the flux flow will be like this. So it will be closing, forming the closed loop through this pattern. It will be forming the closed loop through this pattern. So here, whatever the space is there, that we will say air gap. We are providing some empty space between this is the whatever inner part is there. This is the armature, and remaining this is the air gap, and similarly this is the yoke arrangement. So, and sometimes for the higher readings we may have some interpoles here and some compensating windings here to take care of armature reaction, and for better commutation we will use all these things. So and you have number of conductors here on this armature periphery. So how many conductors we need, what are the sizes of conductor, what is the slot, and finally the performance matters, right? Efficiency, resistance values, and stray losses, and the weight of the armature, weight of the copper. So most of the parameters we are going to calculate in this video, so that you can get better understanding and you can get better feeling how a DC motor, typical DC motor will be, and what are the different things we need to calculate and we need to ensure, and what are the typical values for each parameter based on the experience. So all things we are going to discuss. If you are interested to know all the things whatever we discuss it till now, then join with me, do subscribe to this channel, so that whenever I'm uploading videos you will get notifications. Yeah, keep watch part 2 of this video. Thank you guys, we will meet in next video. Bye.